wife of Robin from the Bee Gees, invites us into their monastic Oxfordshire home and explains how Things Country inspired her first ever art exhibition. Bye-bye for now. Dwina, the wife of Robin Gibb of the Bee Gees, was about to launch her own career when we dropped in. We weren't the only visitors either. Out there in the quadrangle, the clan was in full throttle.
Leaps, so do we. As the water flows, so do we. As the air swirls, so do we. Turning and turning, dancing the dance, as the soil is turned for the seed, as death moves to life, as the seed turns to the soil.
I was thinking the other day, they seem to be using a lot more herbs in the house at the moment.
I know, having dreams about this garden. Terrible food that we've been having on tour.
Yeah, was it
poor? When we come back, it's really nice, yeah. It's so nice to get back to fresh vegetables.
So we'll have to increase the rosemary and the basil.
Rosemary and basil, yeah.
Did you want some of the...
Applemint, yes. Applemint. I think. I'm just going to have a few sprigs. Sometimes I just like to put the sprig into the cup and pour the hot water on it.
Oh, yes.
It's really nice, just as a mint tea. Ah.
You're not going to be cooking Sunday lunch yourself, are you?
Well, I do sometimes, but...
Do you?
Usually I spend a lot of time doing my artwork and my writing and things, so I have a macrobiotic chef.
Tell me about this organic gardening, though. How important is that to you?
Oh, very important, especially for my son. And he doesn't know what the taste of meat is, or even Coca-Cola or anything like that.
Not at all.
Whoa, one hand.
Nice.
This is the fruitful and admittedly fairy tale world of Dwina Murphy Gibb, a world of poetry, folk music and art. She's happiest when the jet setting relents for a few weeks and she can ensconce herself in the family home. It's a converted 12th century monastery in Oxfordshire, known to the locals as Chateau BG.
I live in America, but I have a home here which I stay in for a few weeks, every now and again, like Christmas and the summer. It's a mental home. it's nice to put a few decorations up. No.
Does it mean very much to you?
Well, it means a lot to me because I'm English and I live in England and the three brothers are English and we certainly, you know, we don't ever want to sever our ties in Britain because, you know, this is our home, this is our roots here.
It is fearful I am as I observe from afar the land that I have left. It is regretful I am that I see only war and an ever-widening cleft. I watch youth destroyed before they have lived, the old killed long before their time. This is a heritage not easy to forgive and far too bloody in its prime. Fearful I was when I heard of the blast near my own home time. Regretful I was to see that it has torn a greater rent in the gyne.
This is a household brimming with talent. Dwina not only writes poetry, she publishes her own collections and draws. She won her first art competition when she was 4 and is approaching her prime now. Gainmead, the shepherd abducted by Zeus, is typical of her work, based on legend and mythology, rather like the Scottish folk group, the Clan, we saw playing on her terrace. She's espoused their tribal message and loves the music, not to mention the Neanderthal clothing. It does make a change from Massachusetts and Saturday Night Fever.
Dying on the sea of water and tongue.
is how it all started, didn't it, with this picture?
Yes, this is the picture that started my relationship with my wife.
It is fairly erotic. I think I can understand what you must have felt.
It's got a special message in it, you see, saying I love you.
Right.
Which, over the years, I find very hard to find, but it's in there.
I know you're very keen, aren't you, to be known not as a BG wife, but as a painter and an artist in your own right.
Oh, well, I'm very proud of being a BG wife as well, but it's great, actually, because there's so much creativity around, and if I want to work late into the night, you know, my husband understands, and I understand when he wants to work late into the night, so we have a very good working relationship in that way.
How much is Robin supporting you in this exhibition? Will he be
much.
There?
Oh, yes, he'll be there. He'd better be there. No, he will be there. He likes my art. He's the one who's encouraged me most.
Has he?
Yes. He commissioned me to do some artwork. That's how I met him. I really made them string out for a very long time.
Did you? Yeah.
And I've never finished them, and I won't ever finish them. So I feel if I finish them now that...
It might be symbolic.
Yes. I think I just won't finish them.
The Unfinished Symphony.
Dwina's first exhibition was held in Woodstock, that mecca of upper middle class gentility, by Jonathan Poole, the dealer who helped to launch Yoko Ono. I wonder if she's still in orbit. Anyway, it seemed to go down pretty well.
Well, I am slightly biased, but I think it's terrific. It's one of the reasons I was attracted to her in the first place, before I was attracted to her, was her work. She's a very talented lady. I think she's going to go very, very far in the art world. I think she's doing something very unique.
She tells me you do a bit of painting or drawing.
I dabble a bit in the odd thing, you know, the odd line here, the odd face. But, you know, it's...
Are you any good?
No.
Tell me, what about your own future now? Are you at the stage where you're cruising or even thinking of retiring and putting your feet up?
Or put our feet up. We're thinking this way, you know, we're in our 30s, and Madonna's in her 30s, and the Pet Shop Boys are in their 30s. And I think it's a little... We started very young, so we're not in it for the money, we're doing it for the music. Our goal is to keep working.
And taking the fruit and veg, organically grown, of course. When she's not delving into mythology, Dwina's helping Pamela Stevenson in her campaign to keep pesticides away from the things we eat. Do you know, even Robin has to admit now that he quite likes seaweed and veggie burgers. But food, folklore, poetry and paintings, it's all part of Dwina's grand scheme. And as her pictures at £500 a piece went like hot cakes, who better to entertain her customers than the Picts themselves?
Well, that was their first appearance on television, and Dwina's. Will it be their last, I wonder? Somehow, I think Robin had been there before.